can't make it without him. No other way. There is no other way. Amen. And so I'm glad that the saints understand the importance of us having God in our lives. Can't do nothing without him. We can't breathe without him. We couldn't rise this morning without him. And so it's good to be reminded in that selection that there is no other way. No other way. And so God bless you. Thank the choir again for blessing us. And at this time, we're going to ask that you bow with us. God, we thank you for letting us stand again. We thank you for the time that has come. We do pray that you enable us to preach your word, oh God, to be that voice, oh Lord, for this occasion. Oh Lord, that your spirit now will go forth and use us, oh God, and that your power will be manifested through the preaching of your word. Bless the hearer today, that they too will certainly be blessed and will be encouraged and strengthened and assured that we can trust the word of God. And we thank you now in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Those that have your Bibles, we do invite you to look with us to the book of Genesis, chapter 12. We want to look at verses 1 through 3 of this passage. Genesis, the 12th chapter, verses 1 through 3. And we know that is the first book of the Bible, of the Old Testament. Amen. The book of origins, as it has been defined. And so we're going to look at this passage today. And those that have it, let us go forth and read. Now the Lord has said unto Abram, get thee out of thy country, and from thy kindred, and from thy father's house, unto a land that I will show thee. And I will make of thee a great nation, and I will bless thee, and make thy name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. And I will bless them that bless thee, and curse him that curseth thee, and in thee shall all the families of the earth be blessed. Amen. In keeping with our thought on last Sunday, we again raise the thought how to bless and stay blessed. Amen. I am just, as they say, so convinced with how the Spirit has been leading us through this preaching experience, because this subject is so diverse that I don't think one passage, as they say, sufficiently defends it. And so we thank the Holy Spirit. I did say on last Sunday that it be His will to lead us. We will again continue with this subject matter. And so we look today to this somewhat familiar text. And we do see one who stands out in the scriptures. And so as we continue to establish this present truth, it's important that we see how the Word of God reveals to the believer that blessing them is in the plan of God. The how of this process is in the hands of God. Now, if we understand that we are blessed, there has to be a reason for how we knew we were. Now, this passage before us serves as evidence that the blessings that are available to us this present day began with the promises that God made with Abel. Now, he has been referred to as the father of faith. And God called Abram, as we learn here, to go and look for a city. He was called to go not knowing where he was going. He was called to God to go not knowing whom he would meet when he arrived at his destination. He was called to go not knowing where he would eat or where he would sleep or where he would live. He was just called to go.
Yes, sir.
Now, the reason Abraham could go was because he possessed faith. He had faith in God.
Yeah.
One of the keys of being blessed and staying blessed is faith.
Yeah.
Faith is the key that unlocks the door of blessing.
Yes, sir.
God promises to bless those who have faith.
Yes.
See, listen, if you search the scriptures, even in the time of Jesus, the reason many were healed, were delivered, were set free, is because they had faith. And because of their faith, they got blessed.
Yeah.
And see, God promises, no matter how we look at this, blessings to those who have faith.
Right.
It is impossible, and we understand this, to please God without faith.
Well,
therefore, faith lets us please God and then be blessed.
Right.
Notice there's a promise that if we please God, he will what? Bless us. And I wonder in the house, is there anybody who's serious about wanting to please God? Listen, Abraham's experience in this text is to be admired.
Yeah.
He didn't go out seeking for God to bless him. It was God who called out to him.
Yeah.
And it's amazing when it's God's intent to bless you.
Yeah.
It confers that a blessing comes from God. Who gives at times undeservedly.
Yeah.
And he does this to whom he wants, whatever he wants, and however he wants. All this is evident in this present text. When God goes forth and tell you he wants to bless you, you are being blessed to stay that way. Anybody hear me today? But listen, when God wants to bless you, he ain't just doing a temporary thing. He is blessing you for a lifetime. God blesses so that blessings will remain in our lives. And I wonder, am I talking to someone today? No, today are some blessings that are presently in your life. Yes, I would have to say this, that there are some blessings that are for the moment. Yeah, but I'm talking about blessings that are permanent.
Yeah.
That have what been attached to you, and not only you, but to your seed.
Yeah.
What God was establishing with Abraham was how he could bless him, and he could be blessed to stay that way.
Because
if we want to have a life that guarantees blessings, don't be afraid. If God wants to bless you, to use you. Let me hold that for a moment, because I don't think some of us know that God likes to interrupt our lives. And God wants to bless you, that he can use you for a greater task. And when you are used by God, he blesses you for the assignment.
Yes.
Some may wonder, why would God interrupt Abraham's life? Well, whatever he was doing is because he knows us better than we know ourselves. Everyone that God has called, he has blessed. And I pray today, if you're with me, that God has blessed you. And sometime, I like I said on last Sunday, we confuse blessings. We just don't get it. Blessings ain't wants. Blessings really are needs. Blessings are things that God finds reasons to bring into your life. And some are just looking for these quick fixes, these quick things for God to do. And there's some of us in here who looking for God to let us hit the lottery or, amen, let the slots, amen, be in my favor. And if you are someone in God, God does not operate in the ways of man. He has blessings that are authentic.
Yes.
Amen. That are original. And they are really designed just for you.
Yeah.
And I just believe that we got blessings with our names on them.
Yeah.
Y'all didn't hear me, but But if Adam's got to tell himself that, I mean, there's some blessings with my name. Amen. Already over. And we got to get convinced today that we can't confuse the blessings of God with the materialistic way of the world. Can I help somebody? God knows what you need. He knows what you need to help you survive. And even the sinners who don't know God stand in line for the same thing. That's why Jesus said, listen, don't take no thoughts about tomorrow. Listen, don't worry about what you're going to put on. In fact, some of us already know we got a wardrobe there. Amen. We probably ain't have no more space to put nothing else in. But God, if you want to hear me today, he already knows what you have need of. And we as the people of God got to get it right. Some reason we got it twisted. Oh yes, we done got so influenced by the world view that we don't realize that God's blessings are numerous. There's no shortage when it comes to God wanting to bless. God ain't got to go back and check in heaven, do I still got something here to give? God manifest the blessing. Listen at the word of his mouth.
That's right.
And that's why when we look at this today, you got to admire Abraham. He was a man that really was not, if you want to say, a believer of God just yet. Amen. And that's why God chose to call him out. And the thing that ought to help us is that he heeded the voice of God. He did not ignore this voice. Because verse 1 will indicate, now the Lord, he said unto Abram. And look at what he tells him, get out of that country of yours. Amen. From your family. From your father's house. Unto a land that I will show you. Now, if that was us today, I wonder what we have done. I wonder what we have heeded the voice of God so quickly. And thank you, Brother Ross, because obedience is the key. We said this on last Sunday. If you really want to stay blessed and know how to be blessed, you got to first obey the voice of the Lord. It's not if you got to wait a moment and say, well, Lord, let me get back to you. I got to go talk to my father. I got to talk to the wife. And I got to see how they feel about me packing up and leaving them and going to a place. But hear this. Going to some place I don't even know. Amen. That's the faith element in being blessed. You got to take God what? And his word. And so therefore, Abraham hears this from God, and God challenges Abraham to heed his voice. He says, to a land that I will show you. Now, how am I going to pack up and go, and I don't know where I'm going? I don't even know the place. But yet God says, unto a land that what? I will show you. Now, ain't nobody here today willing to just take God for his word without saying, Lord, how am I going to do this? Lord, how am I going to take off and leave what I have here and then do as you say? But Abraham, we saw no way in the text where he bargained with God, because the first thing we see is that God promises to bless him. And when verse 2 come around, this helps to me smoothen what God says. Because it's really not the verse 4 you'll see in the text that Abraham went forth and departed. But it's verse 2 and 3 that helps us to see why he was willing to do as the Lord said. Now, first of all, God said, I'm promising you to bless you. Amen. And he says this in such great light that I'm going to do this. The way I'm going to bless you, I'm going to make you a great nation. And Abraham probably had to wonder, I first of all don't have a child. I'm 75 years old, man. My wife Sarah is 65, man. And we yet have not received an heir. But He said that I'm going to make of you a great nation. I promise to bless you this way. And I'm not going to stop there. I'm going to make your name great. Now when God wants to bless you, there are some things he's going to do on your behalf. Some of us want to put our name out there. But can I tell you this? Let God do that. If you stay humble, God will exalt you. In due time, he'll let your name be remembered. And the scriptures prove that when we get all the way over to the New Testament, they're still speaking of Abraham. But let me bring up speed even to this 21st century. We're still making reference to this man Abraham. Because God said, I'm going to make your name great. Amen. And some of us don't realize that, as they say, what the quality got to go in before the name goes out. I just believe with God, he wants some things to go in first before he make the name great. Now listen, God didn't make the name great just yet here. It came with some things, some conditions that were going in until finally someone said in the name of the father of Abraham. Y'all know when some of us pray. Amen. We want to say Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And brothers and sisters, God promised to bless him. And God will indeed do what he says. He will make you great. He will even make you a great nation. It don't take God a whole lot to do anything. He took two people. He took, listen, Abraham and Sarah, and made a great nation. Because if you know the track record, Isaac came forth. Isaac had Jacob. Also, what, Esau? But it was Jacob who went forth to bring the 12. That became what, the 12 tribes of Israel. And from that point, God did what he said. And I just wondered today, anybody here want to know how to be blessed and stay blessed? You got to believe what God says to you. You got to take him at your word. And so, secondly, God promised to make him a blessing. And somebody don't want to fall in that line that when God said, you shall be a blessing. Anybody want to be a blessing to somebody? Amen. I don't just want to live for myself. I want to be able to know I'm a blessing to somebody that I know when my living is over here, amen, it won't be in vain. Amen. That when I die, that somebody be saying, Pastor Adams, he blessed my life. And God can make sure, brothers and sisters, that if you receive what he says, amen, you can be a blessing. And I'm glad God did it this way with Abraham. He made Abraham realize that you're going to be a blessing. You don't see it right now, but I'm professing that. Guess what? You're going to be a blessing. Anybody here wants to be in that? I want to be a blessing. Amen to somebody in this life. Because the trick of the world and the devil is to live selfishly. Think about three important people. Me, myself, and I. But brothers and sisters, you can't be a blessing.
That's right. Come on now.
When the focus is me, myself, and I.
That's right.
But you got to be a blessing when you know you got to surrender some things.
Yeah.
You got to let go of some things. You got to deny yourself. And believe that God can still let you be a blessing. So Abraham hears two powerful things that God promises to bless him. That God promises to make him a blessing. But this is the part I love. He promised this last thing. To bless others because of him. It's all there in verse 3. He says this, I will bless them that bless thee. Curse him that curses thee. But here it is, and these shall all the families of the earth be blessed. Now that just tells me this simple thing, that God promises to bless us. Amen. And let others be blessed as a result of it. Because everyone wants to be blessed by somebody. But why not be the one that is responsible for others being blessed? Amen. I just believe did that when he blessed you.
Yes.
He just don't let your blessings be just for you.
Yes.
But for others to also partake in.
Yes.
And that's what I believe that got Abraham so excited.
Yes.
That he was now ready to go with God.
Yes.
Sometimes God got to tell us all the details.
Yes.
He just don't want to leave us hanging out there.
Yes.
Where the Lord said, I got to leave family.
Yes.
I got to leave my father's house.
Yes.
I got to leave my country and go to a place that I will show you. I told you some of us would have wrestled if God left us hanging there. But to let Abraham see the whole plan, God brought in some blessings. Amen. He said, I'm going to make you a great nation. I'm going to bless you. I'm going to make your name great. And thou shalt be a blessing. I will bless them that bless thee. Curse him that curseth thee. But here is the whole blessing. In thee shall all the families of the earth be blessed. Now just to make it more plain, the reason verse 3 ends the way that it does, there was an ultimate plan in what God said. There was a hidden clause that was not written there. The clause was this, that through Abraham, other families being blessed was because of Jesus. Yes, I got to pull him in. Abraham was the father of many generations. But I got to let you know that Jesus came through those 42 generations. That was the blessing for all the families of the earth. Hey, God, all right. Brothers and sisters, I want you all to know that God wants to bless your life, but you need to know how he can bless you. You need to know how he can keep you blessed. It's all predicated in our faith. I wonder, do we really have faith in God? Do we really take him at his word? Do we really believe that through God all things are possible? To them that believe, I wonder today, anybody here can stand to be blessed? Don't fool me right now. Can you really stand that God can bless you? Don't fool me right now. You ought to be serious that God wants to bless your life. He told you last week there are some terms that God has provided. And if you want to be blessed, you got to do what he said. You got to believe what he said. You got to have faith in what God said. If you want him to bless you, it's all how do you stand with God. Anybody here want to have a relationship with their God? Do you want to walk with him? Do you want to talk with him? To talk back to you. When he talks to you, he's setting you up for a blessing that you could not imagine, that you did not ask for. Abraham is truly the exception. This man didn't know the plans for his life. But I'm glad God knows the plans of our lives. He wants to bless us. A good end that not only we can enjoy it, but I see and be involved in the blessings of God. Anybody here know that you're blessed because of God? Know that God has put his hands on your life, and no weapon formed against you can prosper. Thank God wants to bless your life.
something. You're going to leave out something. He promised something that he would be there. I wonder in the house, do you believe that God has been with you? Have I got a witness? Do you believe that because of the law, we're still here? To stay in that blessed moment. Everybody feel you there? I don't know about you. I believe I'm blessed. Coming and going. Amen. And how he want to keep you blessed. I just believe it's a position that we find ourselves in. I said on last week about that ED on bless. That state of position that you're already in. God had already blessed you, but now you are staying in that position. And that's why I'm glad saints can say this at times if you ask me how I'm doing. I'm blessed.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
I'm blessed.
Yeah.
Anybody blessed?
Yes.
Do you feel blessed? Yes. Did you wake up blessed? Yes. Did you go to sleep blessed? And I want to let you know that God is still
yes.
the same God in this text.
Yes.
He done it for us.
Yes.
Amen. We may not be Abraham, but we're falling in the inheritance of Abraham. Because Jesus was that inheritance. And I'm glad you ought to get yours. Like the choir saying, get your inheritance. Because I'm glad I'm the lender and not the borrower. I'm the head. I'm not the tail. And stay blessed. Oh yeah, I feel it. I feel it.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, we're gonna get more of this.
Yeah.
Yeah, oh yeah. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Well, somebody ain't convinced that God knows how to bless you and let you stay that way. Oh yes. Wait for next Sunday. Amen. There's more to be included. This day. Amen. We want to extend the invitation to someone that might be present today.